Fountain from the Drover's Journal here, and I'm standing here at Outback Shorthorns with one of the rising stars in the breed. He won't say that, but I am, Greg Schiller. Greg and his father Dallas, or the Schiller family, own Outback Shorthorns, and some of the cows there, right there behind us. So, Greg, can I say you've got a beautiful herd?
Thank you, Tony. I appreciate that.
No, I do, because obviously, what's your best price so far? What, 16 grand or something?
23 we've sold for.
23. And when you look at the herd, it's just, you can see why the Outback cattle have got the reputation that they have. So we were just talking a minute ago about the power of stud foundation, eh? So that formed a fair bit of the...
It really did. I was lucky enough to work for a large-scale commercial company outside of school, and that sort of formed the base of our herd. When they dispersed their herd, I was able to get my hands on some of the best cows of what I thought in that herd, and that we SFA'd those cows and therefore registered the heifers out of them, and that really started our stud with selection of some top end sires that really took us forward.
A couple hundred cows now.
We run about 200 stud cows now and some commercial females that we actually dispersed in October this year.
Right.
So we'll stabilise about 200 stud cows now.
Yep.
Well,
I've been most impressed with the cattle that I've seen coming through, because I've seen some of them that you've marketed. Now, you're also involved day-to-day in a commercial feedlot, so obviously you get to see that side of the industry up close. What do you think of the things that the Shorthorn breed's got to offer the beef industry?
Certainly our performance, inside feedlots, our carcass characteristics. Shorthorns, I think, can certainly match or better Angus in our weight for day, our consumptions, and our carcass attributes as well. I think certainly inside boning rooms and in feedlot performance, as you can see, with some of the feedlot data that's come out of feedlot trials, we're certainly always right up there with Shorthorns.
Yep.
They're certainly an outstanding animal to feed through the feedlot and crosses as well.
Yep. So what are the main things that, I guess, from a feedlot, not a Shorthorn breeder's point of view now, but from a feedlotter's point of view, make Shorthorns attractive?
Your newer style of Shorthorns with a little bit added carcass they've got now, it opens up the markets for them. Certainly still get feedlot performance with boning room yield added in there.
Yep.
And obviously the marbling is another thing. There's still plenty of 120 day and 200 day products getting around. Well, they need to have that marbling, to go to your UK and your Jap ox and those sort of things. They're still kicking around. So they certainly tick all the boxes.
Yeah. No, well, mate, congratulations, both roles in the feedlot and also here with your Outback Shorthorns. And I wish you and Dad all the very best for the future, and keep the faith, my son. Keep the faith.
Thanks, Tony. Appreciate that.
Righto.